Good morning to everybody, and thank you for the committee for inviting me. Today, I will talk about itosomes for transdermal delivery of natural antioxidant molecule, design and activity on 2D and 3D skin model. Itosomes are itosomes are novel transdermal delivery systems. They were described for the first time by Professor Tuito. And we can say that they are a new generation of liposomes composed of phospholipids and ethanol in the composition. And they are suitable for the encapsulation of lipophilic or amphiphilic drugs, such as coenzyme Q10 or caffeic acid, in particular of poor soluble molecules. And they can be used as transdermal delivery systems. This behavior is thanks to the presence of ethanol, because ethanol acts as a penetration enhancer, so disorganize the lipids that compose the stratum corneum, increasing the lipid fluidity and the flexibility of the stratum corneum. After that, the itosomes can interact with the stratum corneum, so penetrate and release the drug into the deep layers of the skin. In particular, in this work, we firstly investigate the composition, the effect of the composition of itosomes in the formulation. In particular, phosphatidylcholine was selected as a phospholipid, and we used a different concentration of phosphatidylcholine, namely 0.6, 0.9, and 1.5. Before the addition of water in the ethanolic solution. So the formulations were characterized in terms of, we can say, inner structure by X-ray diffraction and size by photon correlation spectroscopy. As you can see in the X-ray image, the broadband is indicative of the presence of phosphatidylcholine B layers, and the intensity of the band is related to the phosphatidylcholine concentrations. So the number of B layers composing the vesicles increased with the phosphatidylcholine content. After that, we characterized the vesicles in terms of size and polydispersity, and we monitored the stability of the dimensional characteristics in time. We found that the lowest the phosphatidylcholine concentration, the highest the size stability. And in all formulations, we obtained a unimodal size distribution. Considering this characterization and considering that higher amount of phosphatidylcholine concentration can entrap higher concentration of drug, we selected the formulation with 0.9 of phosphatidylcholine as the best formulation for our aim. So we decided to check the uptake of itosomes, so the interaction of itosomes with cells. So we firstly selected fibroblasts as 2D skin model, and we treated cells with itosomes at 0.9. As you can see by the image, comparing the cells treated with autosomes and the untreated cells, we can detect the passage of autosomes through the cell membrane, clearly evidenced by the arrows in panels C and D. In particular, the possible mechanism of autosome passage is by endocytosis pathway because of the presence of cell membrane invaginations and vesicles within the cytoplasm. We decided to study the same interaction using tissue, so using reconstituted human epidermis, RHE, as 3D skin models, so to verify if autosomes are able to interact with the stratum corneum, in generality the stratum corneum epidermis, and pass through the first strata of the skin. And comparing the image, the panel A with untreated RHE with RHE treated with autosomes, we can see the presence of autosomes in the epidermal layers, indicating the crossing of the stratum corneum by the vesicles characterizing the autosomes. So we can select tissue as a 3D model suitable for mimicking both the human epidermis morphology and the human epidermis physiology. After this pre-formulatory study, we encapsulated two different molecules, so coenzyme Q10 and caffeic acid, into autosomes. And this system was able to increase the solubility and of these molecules and increase the encapsulation of the molecules. In both cases, the encapsulation of the drug was quantitative and almost quantitative, and we can say stable in time up to 3 months after production. In particular, in the case of caffeic acid, the encapsulation, the loading into autosomes was able to increase up to tenfold the solubility of this molecule, and to guarantee the stability of the molecule that is not stable in aqueous solution, because if we look at the graph, the caffeic acid content in aqueous solution underwent complete degradation within 1 month. The autosomes, the unloaded and loaded autosomes, were characterized in terms of size and polydispersity. The mean diameters were around 250 nanometers, and the encapsulation of coenzyme Q10 and caffeic acid did not affect particularly the vesicle size, and the size and the polydispersity of the vesicles were stable. For stable in time, for 3 months. In particular, the dispersity index values indicated a monomodal size distribution for all formulations being below 0.2 of values. After that, the morphology was investigated by Cryotherm. In particular, we compared the morphological analysis of MTR autosomes with autosomes loaded with coenzyme Q10 and caffeic acid. We found the mixed population of unilamellar, multilamellar, and multivesicular vesicles with mostly spherical but also elongated shape. In particular, in all cases, the fingerprint-like structure that is characteristic of the presence of phospholipid bilayers was found in all samples, as already described by the other authors as a typical characterization. And the presence of the coenzyme Q10 and caffeic acid did not particularly affect the supramolecular organization of this kind of molecules, of vesicles, sorry. The X-ray diffraction is similar of that previously described. So the broadband denotes the presence of phosphatidylcholine multilamellar vesicles characterized by the typical bilayers given by the composition of phosphatidylcholine and ethanols. In particular, the profile, X-ray profile of a loaded ethosome is similar to that of ethosome profile, confirming the formation of the phosphatidylcholine multilamellar vesicles. Considering the autosomes with the coenzyme Q10, we studied the antioxidant effect of this formulation firstly on cells. So human health fibroblasts were treated with autosomes, and untreated cells were used as control. And after that, after treatment, they were exposed to a hydrogen peroxide selected as inducer of oxidative stress. After that, the formation of 4-hydroxynonenal, so 4-HNE protein adduct levels were evaluated by immunofluorescence. As you can see in the image, the exposure to hydrogen peroxide induced a significant increase in 4-HNE protein adduct formation, represented by the green fluorescence in control cell. The treatment with ethosomes, the formulation was able to counteract the formation of 4-HNE protein adducts. In fact, the green fluorescence is very low. So the, as you can see in the graph, the exposure to hydrogen peroxide increase in time in untreated cells the levels of 4-HNE, while in the case of cells treated with ethosomes containing coenzyme Q10, the levels of 4-HNE decreased in time. So we can conclude that autosomes with the coenzyme Q10 can exert antioxidative potential, protecting cells against oxidative stress. Of course, we investigated also the antioxidant effect on tissues, so on a 3D skin model. We treated the ethosomes with the tissues with ethosomes, and we exposed tissues to hydrogen peroxide. We evaluated the 4-HNE protein adducts, and as you can see, also in this case, the exposure to hydrogen peroxide induced a significant increase in protein adducts formation. While in the case of tissues treated with ectosomes, the formulation was able to protect skin after the exposure to oxidative stress, and in particular in this case, the antioxidant effect has been exerted also in the deeper layers, because the fluorescence is very low down to the stratum basale, so the ectosomes were able to cross the stratum corneum. Considering the liquid state of the ectosome after production, we selected poloxamer 407 as a thickened agent to obtain a semi-solid consistency of ectosome. So we added the poloxamer to the ectosome formulation, and we investigated the size, polydispersity, and morphology of the obtained system. The vesicles were stable in time. The addition of poloxamer, of course, increased a bit the dimension of vesicles, and affected the regular spherical shape. So we obtained an irregular shape of vesicles, but the typical supramolecular phosphatidylcholine organization was preserved also with the after the addition of poloxamer. Even if the sizes of vesicles increased, the narrow distribution was preserved in time, and vesicle size distribution was stable in time up to 90 days after production. Considering the semi-solid state of this formulation, we investigated the rheology of these formulations, and in the cases of thickened formulation at high temperature, we found that the storage modulus was higher than the loss modulus, indicated that the thermogelling properties possessing by the poloxamer 407 were maintained also after the addition to ectosomes, and all the thickened formulations present elastic behavior above the transition temperature sol gel. In particular, the presence of vesicles create a structured gel network, also confirmed by the X-ray analysis. In fact, in the case of ectosomes loaded with caffeic acid and thickened with poloxamer, the 3D disorder cubic structure produced by the polymer micelles is preserved, and the poloxamer promotes the formation of packed multilamellar structures. At the end, we investigated by Francel's experiment the in vitro diffusion of caffeic acid from an aqueous solution, from a poloxamer gel, from ectosomes, and ectosomes thickened with the poloxamer. As expected, the faster diffusion was obtained with the aqueous solution, and after that by the poloxamer gel. The diffusion from ectosomes was dramatically slower, and also the thickened vehicle ectosomal vehicle was able to control the diffusion of caffeic acid. So also this result was able to confirm the suitability of ectosomes and also the possibility to viscosite to obtain a semi-solid formulation by the addition of poloxamer controlling the diffusion of the drug. So in conclusion, firstly, the preformulatory study was necessary to select the best composition of itosomes and demonstrated that itosomes are suitable transdermal delivery system able to interact not only with cells but also with 3D models such as reconstituted human epidermis. The multilamellar vesicles of around 200 nanometers with the stable site distribution was obtained and characterized. Then the encapsulation of two different drugs, coenzyme Q10 and caffeic acid, corroborated the suitability of this kind of delivery system for poor soluble drugs, improving both their solubility and stability. The efficacy of the encapsulated coenzyme Q10 in protecting the skin from oxidative stress confirmed the effective passage of the vesicle through the skin, and the viscosization of a autosomal vesicular system allowed with the Poloxamer 407 allowed to obtain a semi-solid formulation that is able to control the diffusion of drugs with respect to solution. So I would like to thank my research group, so Professor Rita Cortesi and Professor Elisabetta Esposito of the University of Ferrara, our collaborators, and thank you all of you for your attention from Italy.